you're a pilot who plans to visit an airport anytime soon, you'll need to understand the notion of traffic patterns. Sedona's standard traffic pattern follows a 1,000-foot altitude around the main runway. By the time you finish this lesson, you'll have the skills to complete every leg of the pattern, starting with takeoff. Once you're airborne, stay aligned with the runway and climb to 5,400 feet. You'll be going for a left-hand traffic pattern. When you reach your target altitude, begin a turn to the left 90 degrees toward a 122-degree heading. Now you're in the pattern. Get ready for the crosswind section. All right. Continue climbing until you reach the traffic pattern altitude of 5,700 feet. It's time to make your left turn downwind. When the runway appears at the halfway point of your wing strut, that's your mark. You're at a good glide distance. In the downwind leg. Now lower your nose to a cruise attitude and reduce power to 2100 RPMs. Once your speed is in the white arc, add 10 degrees of flaps and prepare for landing. This would be a good time to check and see if the runway is looking good. Also watch out for any other aircraft entering or exiting the pattern. As you fly past the end of the runway, continue until you see it at a 45-degree angle behind you. That's your cue to turn left again, onto the base leg. Now reduce your power to idle. You want to lose altitude while you maintain a cruise attitude. Keep an eye on the runway as you prepare for your final turn. Your speed should be holding at approximately 65 knots. see that? The runway's in full view. Be sure to keep the aircraft centered on approach. If you're too high, add flaps. Too low, add power to maintain the glide path. We are wheels down. Apply brakes to slow the aircraft, but never come to a complete stop on the runway. If other aircraft are looking to land, you'll have to move. Proceed to one of the taxiways on the right. You did well. You're on your way to becoming a solid pilot. Keep it up.